Hello day everyone. In last class we have discussed about the microscopes. What would be the magnifying power of the microscopes? How many types of microscopes we are having? That is simple microscope and compound microscopes. And we have seen the expression for the magnifying power of the simple microscope and also the compound microscope. Then what would be the purpose of using these microscopes? To increase the size of the object to a number of times. If 1 degree of the size will be increased to the 100 degrees or 20 degrees depending upon the lenses what we have used on the microscope. These purpose of the microscopes are to observe the nearer objects or a small size objects to a bigger size, to magnify. Then how do we observe the things which are at a far nearer to our eye, closer to our eye? It has a planets or a distant buildings or a trees. How can you get nearer to our eye? Yes, you know that by using, you might have been trained with binoculars. For what purpose do you use these binoculars? To observe the distant object nearer to you, but this is what only the objects nearer to you which are surrounding you. But then, how can you observe the planets, stars are very far of objects? Then we have to use a telescope. The purpose of the telescope to observe the distant objects nearer to our eye, closer to the eye, that is at near point. Let us discuss the telescope. What is the purpose of using telescope? To observe the distant object nearer to our eye, or for observing the two objects distinctly. That is what we are using these telescopes. In last class we have seen about the microscopes. Again, in microscope, we know that the object we have seen less focal length and eye lens is having more focal length compared to the object. Now, we discuss about the micro telescopes. In telescopes, let me start with the astronomical telescope. In astronomical telescope, what are we doing that? In telescope, we have two types of lenses. The purpose of using this telescope is to observe the distant object nearer to our eye. That means you have to gather the light from a infinity distance. From a long distance, we need to gather the light. Light gathering power should be more. Now, if you want to gather the more amount of the light, then we need a more aperture of the lens. That's what the object you should have more focal length compared to the eye length in this telescope. But in microscope, object is having less focal length and eye length is having more focal length. Is it? Let me draw. This is what we know. Object which is having more focal length and the size of the aperture of this lens is more, and we know it is what the optical center, a line passing through this optical center is prisma lens and center circle lens. See that object is at infinity, we are observing a planet. When you are observing a planet or stars, then what will be the distance of the planet or stars from us? At infinity, at very long distances. For that purpose, when the object is at infinity, what will be the nature of the light which are incident on the object? Infinity means almost the light is very parallel to each other. Parallel beam of light rays are incident on the lens. Is it? Then, let me take a parallel beam of light which is incident on this lens. Parallel beam of light, the light which is passing through this optical center, not deviated. Whereas, the light which is passing through the this lens by making some angle, then we have used here convex lens of object to, this is what object to lens, focal length is what f naught, then convex lens which will be converges the light rays falling on it, then the light rays are falling on it. This is what here, this is what the light rays which are incident on this lens. Then convergence of light rays. Now we know that if the light rays are parallel to each other, parallel to the principal axis, then they converge to a point on a principal axis which we call it as a focus point. But if the parallel beam of light is incident obliquely to the principal axis, then what will be happening? The converging point is not on the principal axis, but at a plane which is normal to the principal axis, and that plane we call as a focal plane. So that this point is a image which is A, B, inverted. That means whatever you have taken, that is object, for that corresponding object it is the image. Now here we have object. What is the distance from here to here optical center? Wherever we got, this is what focal plane of the object to, focal plane of the object to. And for this one, I have taken now a lens of short focal length. This is called eye lens. Now you can observe from here to here, if it is making an angle alpha, alpha is the angle subtracted by the image formed by this object. And this image of the object will be act as a object for the eye lens. Then what you get here? Light ray which is taking parallel to the principal axis. And ray which is. Now, if this image of the object is within the focus point of the eye lens, then where do you get the image? On the same side, inverted, magnified. So let us see here if it is f naught, and this is adjusted that even the focal length of the eye lens is also at the same point. Let us take here one ray, light ray is passing through this one. Then what if the angle is obtained here? Beta. If it is within the focus point of the eye lens, if the image of the object is within the focus point of the eye lens, where do you get the image? Let us take here. This is f naught and it is what? Fe. This is, then object is in between optical center and focus point. The image will be erect and inverted. Then here you can observe this what? AB, A dash, B dash, and A double dash, B double dash. Now from this one, we observe what do you mean by the magnifying power of the telescope. magnifying power or magnification, angular magnification of the telescope is equal to visual angle subtended by the eye with the instrument. So visual angle subtended by the final image with the instrument to the visual angle subtended by the eye. Visual angle of image with the instrument by visual angle of object with the eye. Here it is equal to m is equal to of instrument beta. Let me take here it is beta by here it is what alpha. That it is alpha. Now from this one you can observe that one tan alpha for small angle is what you can write tan alpha is equal to beta. Beta means here h by f e or which is nothing but ue. Ue represents what? Object distance of eye lens. Is it? Object distance from the eye lens by magnifying power is equal to by for tan alpha h by f naught. Now what we can write here? f naught by ue. That is what the general expression for the magnifying power of the telescope. F naught by ue. Ue represents what? Object distance from eye lens. Can you tell what would be the length of the telescope? L is equal to, you can observe here, F naught plus UE. F naught represents what? Focal length of the object tube. FE represents what? Focal length of the eye lens. Can you tell which is at more focal length? F naught is greater than FE. Focal length of the object is greater than focal length of the eye lens. Now, let me try to get the expression for the magnifying power of the telescope for near point and for infinity, at a far point or at infinity. When image formed at infinity, infinity represents, that is a comfortable view for the observer. Infinity, image formed at infinity. Then what you can take here? How can you take here? We know already magnifying power is equal to what? F naught by UE. UE represents what? Object distance from the eye lens. Now, image formed at infinity. Focal length of the eye lens is FE. Then what would be the object distance per eye lens? From lens formula, 1 by VE minus 1 by UE is equal to 1 by FE. From this one, 1 by infinity minus 1 by UE is equal to 1 by FE. That represents here, UE is equal to minus FE. Here negative sign object distance take plus, then u is equal to fe. Therefore magnifying power of the astronomical telescope is equal to f naught by ue. Ue is nothing but what? fe then m is equal to f naught plus f a. For what? Image formed at infinity. When image formed at infinity, when do you get the image at infinity? If the image of the object is at exactly at focus of the eye lens, then we get the image at infinity. So that what you can write? The length of the telescope L is equal to f naught plus f e. Only in this case we get f naught plus f e for a comfortable view of the observer of the eye. Now, if you want to get the image at infinity, that is what the magnifying power is f naught by f e and L is equal to f naught plus f e, then how to get the image for near point? Image formed at near point. Near point. You can observe here, we have drawn the diagram for near point. Near point. If it is for far point, then what you have to do? This. The position of the image of the object to exactly at the focus point of the eye lens, so that the image will be at infinity. You get these two rays are parallel to each other. Now, whenever the image is at near point, then what is known? V e is equal minus d. Minus d, that represents what? Near point. D represents near point. What do you mean by near point? What is the near point value for the normal eye? 25 centimeter. D is. And then 1 by V E from this one. Our purpose is to find 1 by U E value, and then you substitute that value here. 1 by U E value or U E value. Then you can write here 1 by V E minus 1 by U E is equal to 1 by F E. 1 by minus V minus 1 by minus U E is equal to 1 by so that what can you take here? Minus into minus plus 1 by u e. Then 1 by u e is equal to minus 1 by d goes to the side, means plus 1 by d. 1 by d plus 1 by f e. 1 by d plus 1 by d. And this 1 by u e value subtracted in this magnifying power of the telescope. General expression. What is general expression? F naught by u e. 1 by u e, therefore magnifying power of the astronomical telescope when it is at a near point, image formed at near point, f naught into 1 by u e. 1 by u e is nothing but what? 1 by d plus 1 by f. 1 by d plus 1 by f. Now, you take 1 by f e is common. F naught by f e take common. Then what do you get here? F e by d plus 1. So that I write here 1 plus f e by d is the magnifying power of the micro telescope when the image formed at a near point. Can you tell what will be the length of the telescope in this case when image formed at a far near point? L is equal to f naught plus f naught plus, because it is always at f naught because of the image at object is at infinity forms image at focus point. F naught plus what will be the distance of the focus point? F e. But here what you take? U e. Because when the image is formed at near point, the object distance of the eye lens is not equal to focal length of the eye. That's what we should write compulsory. L is equal to V naught, F naught plus U E. These are the magnifying power of the astronomical telescope for the image formed at infinity and image formed at near point. The same diagram, we don't need to get confusion. Even if you want to get the image at far point, so as we have done in previous topic, that is what compound microscope, how we have drawn the diagram for the formation of the images for near point and far point, the same thing. Just you have to remember, if you want to get the image at near point, the object should be within the focus point. If you want to get the image at infinity, the object should be at focus point so that you will get the image at infinity. Let me show that also. Here, I hope you understood this one. The magnifying power of the telescope is the visual angle of the image with instrument to the visual angle of the object with the eye. The same diagram, this is for near point. For far point means object you have taken and take the light ray, parallel beam of light ray which is incident on this object 2 and passes the straight and this is what the image and this is F naught. Now whatever we take the eye lens, the eye lens focus point is at the same point, FE. That means what is it? Object is at focus point, where do you get the image? At infinity. Then one more, I try, take and this one, this what? These two are parallel to each other, then the image forms at infinity. Now you can observe, this is F0 and here it is FE. In this case, length is F0 plus FE and magnification is what? M0. F0 by FE, L is equal to F0 plus FE. And one more astronomical telescope, what would be the nature of the final image with respect to the object? It is inverted, is it? Then how can you make it erect? That is doing in terrestrial telescopes. We'll get the to get erect image of the inverted image, to get the image which is to be erect, we have to use one more lens which is placed in between the object and the eye lens, and that lens is called erecting lens. Erecting lens, same as this one, where we have to take terrestrial telescope to observe the planets, of stars, surfaces, land surfaces, to far of objects. We'll use this one. Then what would be done in this terrestrial telescope compared to the astronomical telescope? In this terrestrial telescope, an erecting lens is inserted. An erecting lens is inserted between object and the eye lens, and that should be in between four times of the focal. Therefore, here object 2, here eye lens mean here we take an erecting lens. Are even convex lens, concave lens you can take, or even concave lens you take, but that concave lens or convex lens you can take, depending upon that you have to adjust the distances, but the minimum distance must be here, 4 times of. Therefore, in this case, it is object 2, eye lens, and here what you call erecting lens, to erect the inverted image. Use this lens, erecting lens. The length of the terrestrial telescope is equal to F0 plus 4F plus FE. This is what length of the telescope, terrestrial telescope. In this case, the magnifying power is remains m is equal to f naught by f e, and the length of the telescope is only for comfortable view of an non-plane. But well, if we have the more is the diameter of the aperture of the lens objective, more is the intensity of the light gathering power, so that the image formed is brightness. That's what the purpose of the telescope is, to get the more, to design the telescope with objective with a large diameter, large aperture. Object with a large aperture. The main purpose of the telescope is to objective with a large aperture. For what purpose we have large aperture? Because more is the aperture, light gathering power is more. Light gathering power is more. More is the light gathering power, more is the intensity of the image formed. But it is impossible to design such type of the large apertures of the lenses. Why? It is not comfortable. Large is the aperture, the resolving power is more. What do you mean by the resolving power or resolution? The ability to distinguish two objects clearly. So we have, for example, if you are taking two dust particles, if they are very closer to each other, we cannot identify clearly or separately. But by looking those microscopes or telescopes, we can differentiate it clearly. We can distinguish very clearly. That is what ability of the instrument, that is a resolution or resolving power. Resolution is different again, resolving power is different. We'll discuss further in detail in next topics. That's what here, the purpose of the light gathering power is more, means intensity is more, so that the resolving power of the telescopes will be maximum. But it is not possible to design such type of the large aperture of these telescopes. Is it? It is impossible to design large aperture of lenses. And even it is more expensive. Is more expensive. More expensive. And the supporting is, mechanical support is very difficult. What mechanical? That such type of the, for example, if you are taking large diameter of the aperture of the telescope, which is in Wisconsin, of the size around 40 inch, 1.02 meter of the aperture, diameter of the aperture. Wisconsin, and 40 inch means 1.02 meter. That is 40 inch, 1 meter. That such type of the large lens we cannot support easily. That means there is a problem of keeping, or problem of supporting. It is not safe to, we cannot safe it is easily anyway. That is what mechanical support is a difficult matter. Mechanical support is difficult. And even for what purpose we have used this large aperture of the lenses? Large aperture of the lenses, because of to remove chromatic aberrations. Even we cannot remove the chromatic aberrations also. Chromatic aberrations That is what colored images will be obtained. We cannot control this one. For this purpose, to remove these many also disadvantages of there in the refractive type telescope. These terrestrial telescopes or astronomical telescopes are also called as the refractive type telescope. To remove such type of the difficulties, we'll use nowadays they are using this reflecting type telescopes. What is it? Reflecting type telescopes. Reflecting type telescope. What is the difference between refracting type telescope and reflecting type telescope? In refracting type telescopes, we use lenses, convex lenses, or short focal length and large focal length. Which is having more focal length in the telescope? Either object or eye lens. Object is having less short focal length, more focal length. Why? We have to observe the distant object. Distant object, if you want to observe, you have to gather more amount of the light. For that purpose, the object should have large diameter. To remove such type of these all difficulties, we have to use this one more type telescope, which is called reflecting type telescope. Reflecting type telescope. And this is also called as Cassegrain telescope, and after all the name of the scientist Cassegrain. Cassegrain telescope. Cassegrain reflecting telescope. And in this Cassegrain reflecting telescope, we don't use any type of lenses, just use mirrors. Is it? So you know very well, mirror, if you use mirror, what will be happening? What is the difference to the mirror and lens? Mirror reflects the light, lens refracts the light, is it? And apart that, you can observe, lens is having more density, mass density is more, but for mirror, the mass density is less. To overcome the difficulties, what have we discussed in the refracting type telescopes? We use this reflecting type telescope. In this reflecting type telescope, we don't use any lens, but we use a parabolic mirror. Parabolic mirror. This is parabolic, concave mirror is used. What here? Concave. Parabolic concave mirror. Parabolic concave. What happens here, the light will be from infinity, we will get the light from the infinity, the light and light rays incident on this parabolic mirror. This is also called primary mirror. This parabolic mirror is also called primary mirror. Primary mirror, that means primary means what? First the light rays incident on this mirror, so that we call it a primary mirror. And this is what parabolic concave mirror, known as very well concave mirror. Concave mirror. Whenever the light energy, light rays, parallel beam of the light rays incident on the concave mirror, what will happen? When the light rays incident on the concave mirror at infinity, what will happen? These light rays will be intersected at a point on the reflex, which we call as a focus point. So then what happens? These light rays reflect and incident on a into this focus point of this one. So that here we have. Now again, we'll use one more mirror, which is called elliptical secondary mirror, and this is what convex mirror. Convex mirror. This is also called secondary mirror. Secondary mirror. Secondary mirror. Again, this is what mirror we have. It is a mirror. As it is a mirror, again what will happen? These light rays will be reflected from this one. From this light rays are again reflected. And these reflected rays are made to incident. This is what here we get the image. Where do you get image? We get the image within this case. This is what case of the reflecting tactics. Parallel B. So get object which is at infinity, first incident on a concave mirror, parabolic mirror. And thereafter, again the light rays which are intersecting to a focus point, and those light rays are made to incident on a convex mirror, and these rays are again they form the image which is at a point here, focus point of this one. And now one problem we can observe that one. From where we have to observe the image? Where is the observation point? That observation point is within the reflecting tactics. Reflecting tactics. Is it comfortable for observation? No. If you want to observe, first you have to sit in a case of this reflecting tactics. So that means only the difficulty in this one, the observer whoever want to observe this image, they have to sit here. The position of the lens is in the here observer. Is it the position of the observer should be here? Where? Within. The thing difficulty is in this reflecting back telescope or cross-sectioned telescope is that the observer has to sit in a case and then observer. That is only that expert. Other than that, here we have so many advantages in this reflecting type telescope. What advantages can we observe? Can you tell them? Only this is only the disadvantage. But what are the advantages? What are the disadvantages in the refracting type telescope? What are the disadvantages? Then mechanical support is more difficult. Is it? And chromatic aberrations cannot be removed. Is it? Light gathering power is a problem. Such type of this one. Here we are not using any lens. Then what happens? If you don't use any lens, then there is no chromatic aberration at all. Is it? Then advantages of this one are advantages of the Cassegrain telescope. Advantage of the Cassegrain telescope. No chromatic aberrations. Why there is no chromatic aberration? Because we have used what type of lens or mirrors are used. Because there is no since. No lenses are used in sense. But when we have used these mirrors, for mirrors we have a spherical aberration. Even spherical aberration also can be removed because we have used the parabolic mirrors or elliptical mirrors. Even spherical mirrors also can be minimized. Spherical aberrations. Spherical aberration also minimizing or reducing by using parabolic lens. Parabolic method. And third up next, can you tell which is having more weight? Either a lens or a mirror, lens will be having more weight. And which can you support easily? Mirror can you support or lens can you support? Mirror can be support. That means what? Here there is no difficulty of mechanical support. Mechanical support is very easy. Mechanical support is easy. No mechanical support problem. this is not that much of the expensive compared to the astronomical refracting type telescope, is it? So it is not that much expensive, very cheap compared to that. And compared to this refracting type telescope, this is a cheap. So these are the advantages we have compared to the refracting type telescopes. Reflecting type telescopes are having this much of advantage, but what would be the disadvantage? Only the thing, there is, what is the disadvantage? Disadvantage is to whoever the observer, where from where you have the observer, you should sit in the case of this reflecting type telescope, then you have the only the sitting. Observation is only the problem. Other than that, there is no disadvantage of this reflecting type telescope. Only the observer has to sit in a cage, and observer has to sit in a cage of telescope. That is only the difficult of this reflecting type telescope, is it? Because here these are reflecting type telescope, and so let us discuss one problem related to this telescope. We have a small telescope has an optic length of focal length 140 cm. Then what is given? Write the given information first. Focal length of object 2 is f naught is equal to 140 cm. Whereas focal length of eye lens, FE is equal to what is given? 5 cm. They are asking to calculate the magnifying power, and it is 5 cm magnifying power of the telescope for viewing distant objects. Distant objects, when the telescope in normal adjustment, what do you mean by normal adjustment? Normal adjustment is nothing but for our comfortable view of the eye, which is comfortable when an object is at infinity. That means when image found at infinity, that is the normal adjustment of the telescope. Then let us see what is the magnifying power of the telescope when image found at infinity. When final image found at infinity, image found at infinity, final image found at infinity, magnifying power is equal to f naught by fe, is it? Just now discuss that the magnifying power of the telescope for normal adjustment and for f power. Then for normal adjustment, m is equal to f naught by fe. Just we know those values directly. What is f naught? 140 by 5. That is equal to 28 per infinity. Similarly, final image at near point, when the image found at near point, magnifying power is equal to, let me remember that, f naught by fe into 1 plus fe by d. We know f naught value, fe value, and d represents what? Near point. What is the near point for normal eye? 25 cm. Is it? It's not the way d is 25 cm. Right there. That is equal to f naught 140 by fe by into 1 plus fe 5 by 25 is equal to here 5 times, then 140 by 5 into here 5 plus 1, 6 by 5, it is how many times? 28 times, and it is 5.6. 5.6 into 6, 33.6 is a man sized power for near point. You get the image at near point, and this is a man sized power for image when it is formed at infinity. So in what case did you get the man sized power is more in for when the image formed at the near point, 33.6, but here it is what? 28. But so there is no much difference, but however we consider magnifying power for near point and form at infinity, magnifying power is here less and here it is more, but which is comfortable view? This is only the comfortable view. And let me discuss one more problem related to this. Let us see the next problem. Diameter of moon is 3.5 into 10.3 km. This is what moon. For what is the diameter? This is the diameter of the moon. AB, diameter of the moon. D, let me take it is D. And the diameter of the moon is 3.5 into 10.3 km. Diameter D is equal to 3.5 into 10.3 km. Now, and its distance from Earth is 3.8 into 10.5 km. Is it? We are observing from Earth. From Earth. So, what is its distance? What is its distance? 3.8 into 10.5 km. This is the length of the annual circumference. What will be the annular diameter of image of the moon? What is the annular diameter of the image of the moon? Let us see here. Then, and even they have given in the question that focal length of the eyepiece, focal length of, given, let me write here, focal length of eye lens is 10 cm FE, whereas focal length of the objective is given F0 is equal to 4 meter. 4 meter means how many centimeter? 400 centimeter. So tell me, what would be the magnifying power of the telescope image for this one? Magnifying power is equal to F0 by FE. F0 by FE, that is equal to F0 400 by 10 is equal to 40. Is what magnifying power of this X. Now, but we need to find what you have to calculate. What is the angular image, diameter of the image, this word object, and the angular diameter of the object. Tell me, what is the angle subtended by here? What do you mean by the magnifying power of the telescope? Is the ratio of the angle subtended by the final image with the instrument to the angle subtended by the object with the naked. Is it? So let me, can you find the angle subtended by the object? Angle subtended by the image? Angle subtended by moon. By moon at Earth theta naught is equal to, what is the length of the arc is equal to, this is what, let me take it is like length of the arc, it is the radius, then what we can write, L is equal to r into theta, then theta is equal to what, length of the arc by distance. Let me take here is d, and even diameter of the, and capital D, this is the, we have taken it as capital D, and let us take this is D is equal to 3.82 10 power 5 kilometer. Now, theta naught is equal to what you get here? Length of the arc, D by small d. Capital D by small d is equal to capital D 3.5 into 10 power 3 by 3.8 into 10 power 5 both are in kilometer only, so that we have not converted into the meter, that is equal to here 10 power 3, here 10 power 5 we have, 10 power 5 goes to numerator, 10 power minus 5, 10 power 3 minus 5, 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 2, then 0.5 by 0, 3.5 by 3.8, so which would be less than 1, which is around 0.9 into 10 power minus 2. Then what we can write here, 0.009, which is angle subtended by the moon, 0.009 radian, not in degree. Again, but we need to find not the angle subtended by the object, that angular diameter of image of this moon when we observe it with the telescope. But we know magnifying power of the telescope is equal to angle subtended by the image to the angle subtended by the object. Already angle subtended by the object got 0.009. Then what again? Angle subtended by the image. Angle subtended by image. Theta I is equal to m into theta magnifying power. So what is the magnifying power? We can get that 40. Then theta I is equal to 40 into theta naught 0.00. Is it? That is equal to 0.036. Is it? Zero zero nine, 0.036 is the angular diameter of the image of the moon, which is around 21 degree. So this is what we have discussed today about the telescopes, what types of the telescope we have, astronomical telescope and terrestrial telescope. These two types of the telescopes are the refractive type of telescope. Whereas for refractive type telescopes, we have some disadvantages. To overcome these disadvantages, we use the reflecting type telescopes, and we have so many advantages of the reflecting type telescopes compared to the refracting type telescopes. And just we have assessed that what would be the magnifying power and how to calculate the angular diameter of the images or objects based on this one, and keep practicing these topics of the optical instruments and diagrams and formulas, so that we can get the clarity of the concept of these microscopes and telescopes. And almost we have done this light chapter, which is ray optics and optical instruments. Then you have to revise and practice perfectly for the board exams or competitive exams. Thank you.